Popeye to arm wrestlers is one of our biggest influencers, besides maybe Lincoln Hawk from Over the Top. We all love Popeye for his giant forearms and superhuman strength. But have you ever wondered why Popeye had such big forearms? And did sailors of that time period actually look like that? If so, what caused these significant forearm gains? Popeye is a fictional character based off of a real person. But I don't think the creator of Popeye just pulled the image of Popeye out of the blue. After doing some further research and reading some old Reddit forums, I came across a few answers to my questions. The first stated that it could have been the work involved in large sailing ships. Manual line handling requires a very strong and sustained grip. While a sailor's biceps would have also been well developed, perhaps their forearms were better developed than usual, and they decided to exaggerate this. Another stated that the stereotype of a sailor from this time, they had big forearms from handling tensioned ropes on deck all the time, which required and continues to require exceptional forearm strength and endurance. The sailor stereotype is also the reason for his weathered face, incomprehensible dialect, surly attitude, poor dental health, bad eye, and anchor tattoo. Naturally, being a cartoon, everything is exaggerated to comical effect. So, as it seems, the manual line work, rope pulling, and general deck work required substantial forearm strength. I began watching some old documentaries to see if I could find some of this work in action. What I saw in the films was actually pretty interesting. These sailors were rough and tough, and we couldn't even imagine the lives they lived. Some of the following clips could actually prove our point.
He's on anchor, and he can move it too. He's 240 pounds of muscle, and what a man. On his 56th voyage around Cape Horn, more than any man I ever heard of, but he is a super seaman, and I said, there's nothing I could do better than follow his lead in how he survived that many times around the horn. Here they have time below, and they mend their clothes in their time below. Here the skipper's an expert on everything aboard ship. Look at the size of his hands cutting this fellow's hair. The trouble is to get some scissors to get on his fingers, where you have to use special ones.
On the line, neither one of them's fastened, you see. And so why should you be? Just pay attention and get a hold of something. And it'd be silly to let go, wouldn't it? And as I said, there's no safety regulations whatsoever.
The side lights, red to port, green to starboard, found on every ship. Now I'm going down the stay from the top of the foretopmast to the end of the bowsprit, some 17 stories down. And of course, you're not supposed to use your legs for gripping the stay. If you do, you'll wear out a brand new pair of dungarees in one trip down. Simply hand over hand up, hand over hand down, and no sliding. That's only done in Hollywood when they get something special on their hands.
So just in these first few clips, you can already hear the narrator talking about how dangerous the job was and how important having a strong grip and strong hands were. You also hear him talk about how there were men on these ships that were 240 pounds of pure muscle. These guys didn't even go to the gym and probably had horrible nutrition. He also talks about the skipper having huge hands that were so big that they had to specially make scissors for him. Pretty impressive stuff. But what's really impressive is this next feat of strength. Check out this video.
That is absolutely not only frowned upon, you just can't do it with any skin left. Now, I read about a fellow, again, I didn't know whether it was a truthful book or just a novel of some sort, and a fellow came down the edge of sail, so I gave it a try, and another fellow got pictures of me, and I found I could do it, even though I had to hold the fingers straight and thumb straight and pinch the canvas between the ends of my fingers and thumb, a most insecure feeling, but it did work. And when we showed these pictures, the captain, no lean on it at all. It greased our potatoes, though. I'm in the center now, sewing sails. The sailmaker's at my right with the officer's cap on.
I didn't appreciate the danger. I certainly do. When I look back on it, I shudder to think what we did.
No safety harness and they were unheard of. This was our safety harness. Strong arms.
There you have it. Right from the sailor's mouth. These guys didn't have safety equipment. All they had to rely on was their strong arms. Out on the sea, it was life or death. They didn't have the luxury of lowering the weight when they got too heavy, or doing less reps when they got tired. I also wanted to show this picture I have up on the screen. This sailor's forearms, for his size, are massive and definitely unproportioned to the rest of his arm. Pretty impressive stuff in my opinion, and definitely Popeye-ish. For the duration of the video, I included some videos of my sailor-inspired workout. So here you can see me using my endless rope machine. As noted earlier in the video, it seems like most of the sailor's forearm and hand strength comes from rope pulling and all that manual rope work that they do. You can do a couple different angles on this. You can see me pulling it up almost like a lat row here. You can pull it down, which isolates the flexors. You can see I'm pulling it up here, which works the brachioradialis. And here's just a close-up of the pulling the rope down. I like to supinate the wrist as I pull it down. That really gives you a good forearm pump. Right here, you can see I'm just doing short little spurts of hammer curl. And this machine actually has 7 levels to it. I believe this is on level 7, and you can definitely tell I'm struggling a lot more than what I was earlier. I'm sure you're wondering, that looks like a wrist roller. I highly doubt sailors were using a wrist roller while aboard a ship. Well, take a look at this photo and I'll let you be the judge. I'm no historian on the types of equipment that sailors used, but to me, this looks like some type of roller or device used to wind something up or reel something in. If they were doing this with any type of weight, it definitely would have stressed the forearms. Thanks for watching, everybody. And let me know, did old-time sailors have Popeye forearms? And if so, what do you think contributed to those forearm gains? We'll see you next time.